All right, so today it's November 28th, 2023. And I just now lugged a bike of a friend of mine. And in this video, I'm gonna cycle with two bicycles. So over here on the right is my buddy's bike. He had a volleyball accident and his bicycle was still parked at the volleyball hall. So I decided, you know what? I'm gonna grab your bike and bring it to your home, because that's, you know, what buddies do. So in this video, you'll see me cycling, with the left bike. On my left hand is my own bike.
Hey Siri, send a message to Remco.
Oh yeah, now I'm sending a message to Remco, that's my buddy, so, with Siri.
You better have some food in your house right now.
Yeah, I was very hungry.
Yes.
Okay, so now Siri sent this message to Remco, and then in a moment I'll send another message to Remco. Here I am. This is in front of some high school. The kids are free for some reason. I don't know, it was like 11 o'clock or something. Not even. I'm like, yeah, okay, move. This guy also just standing here. Up. So, it was not easy. My wrist is still, you know, like, okay. Had some extra cardio exercise here. My wrist, of course, it was broken once last year, so yeah, I felt it, you know? I think it was the first time for me also cycling with two bikes since my broken wrist. It's been a while.
Hey Siri, send a message to Remco.
Send a message again. And bread, probably.
And bread.
Because I just wanted him to have some bread, you know, some sandwiches in his house.
Yes.
And at the moment of recording, I'm actually sitting in his house right now. So he's going to an MRI scan right now for his knee. Yeah, so he had a volleyball accident, stuff like that happens. And I'm sitting here now in his house doing this audio recording for the bicycle route I just now had, you know, like 30 minutes ago. So yeah. So, and I thought, yeah, why not narrate it? It's been a while. It's been a while since I narrated. So we're starting off here in Amsterdam East. This is Oostpoort on the left side. Oostpoort is like a shopping mall slash district. And in one of my most watched TikTok videos, I was also cycling here. There were some aggressive, quote unquote, aggressive kids, you know, spitting when I was, you know, coming towards them, stuff like that. And it went quite viral on TikTok, let's say. I kind of forgot, but I think it was like 1.5 million views, and I got like, I don't know, 100, I have like a few hundred followers on TikTok, not doing anything over there, so 1.5 million views, it's pretty good for such a small TikTok account, and I'm more into YouTube. So here I am, so the second bike, you hardly see it at this moment actually, but yeah, I'm holding it with my right hand. You see the steering wheel maybe at the bottom here a little bit. And yeah, the thing is that if there are speedy cyclists coming now, as you'll see in this video a couple of times, then I'm not able to, you know, divert. Eh? It's very difficult for me to, you know, make space. And most people on the bike, oh yeah, and most experienced cyclists know that when you see, you know, a person cycling with two bikes, this person has a rough time and you're not gonna behave like an asshole. But as you'll see in this video, there's of course one person with a Van Moof bike who was in a rush or something, I don't know. And he was ringing his bell. Well, yeah, I could not move. Huh? I'm holding two bikes. Okay, look at this girl now here with the black jacket.
Yeah, how are you? Go.
Yeah, I said to her, yeah, go. It's okay, ga maar. Yeah, go ahead, go. Because I just, you know, wanted to go past her and she was like in slow motion going to the left. And I have two bicycles, eh? Okay, I'm not gonna mention that I have two bicycles. I'm gonna try not to mention anymore. Because you, as a listener of this video, already know. Listener slash viewer, I feel like I'm doing a podcast right now. So, I'm saying something while cycling, yeah. These two are also very Go to the left, eh? They want to go to the left, but they stay on the right side. Go to the left, guys. Come on. Jesus. Yeah, man, man, man. Okay, so on the left, that's the Tropical Museum of Amsterdam. I don't recommend you to go there. I mean, it's nice, but if you... Okay, I'm talking in the video also. I'm still talking about those two dudes. But anyways, the Tropen Museum, the Tropical Museum. I mean, you can go there if you've seen all the other museums. You understand? It's not on the priority list. Eh? Go to Van Gogh, go to Rembrandt, go to Anne Frank, go to the Modern Art Museum, Adam Tower, etc., etc., etc. If you've seen that all, then sure, you can go to the Tropen Museum. I mean, the architecture is nice. But for the rest, the stuff you see in that museum, it's like a world, you know, world museum. You see it anywhere in the world, museums like this, so. You can go to Berlin, you can go to Tokyo, you can go to Las Vegas and see a museum like that. Here, this woman's waiting. I thought, you know what, I'm just gonna go in front of the car, you don't see the car. Sometimes you gotta take risks. Not too big, of course, but especially when you have two bikes, mentioning it again. Yeah, every time you stop, you know, it's just hard to get started again, so. I just want to, you know, if I'm cycling, I'm gonna keep on cycling as much as I can. No stopping. So I started off this cycle route in the east of Amsterdam, and we're going to my buddy who's living in Old South, the Old South of Amsterdam. So, yeah, a different district. Here on the right is the Muiderpoort. I made a video about the Muiderpoort gate. It was once a gate of Amsterdam. I made a video about it, but no one seems to watch it. It's one of my worst performing videos ever. And to tell you the truth, I've put a lot of work in it. And you know, at that point I decided, you know what? I'll stop making these little history videos. Because no one is actually watching it, you know, except for one of my buddies in Malta, Jasper. He's enjoying it, but yeah, that doesn't pay the bills, huh? And you know what, actually it still doesn't pay the bills anyways, but yeah, it's a proverb. And maybe once, you know, I might continue to do little history videos if enough people are willing to watch it, or, you know, I mean, yeah, it's just so much work, you know, to look everything up, etc. Yeah. Yeah, so okay, this part of the road is a little bit boring maybe. Not much is happening. But I will go through some very crowded areas in a moment. I just have to, you know, get in the south. So this road is just, you know, just straight ahead, straight ahead. But once I'm in the pipe area, the pipe, P-I-J-P, it will get more fun. So, if you want, you can already skip ahead in the video, and otherwise, you're welcome to just hang out here on this boring part, yeah, this boring road. I don't even know the name. Imagine living there. I mean, the view is nice. All these cars non-stop. Yeah. So keep the windows closed, I guess. I was gonna say also, yeah, it's November, eh? November 28th, 2023. And as you can see, the weather is still, you know, quite okay. It was snowing in the east of the Netherlands, but we're in the west. Oh, this was the Van Moof driver. But we don't hear him. I mean, he was ringing his bell. But maybe because I'm talking right now, we didn't hear it. Anyways, he was ringing his bell, and yeah, what do I do? Yeah? Can't do anything. And Van Moof is this brand of e-bikes. It's a Dutch brand, and they went bankrupt or something. So everyone wears a Van Moof, and if it breaks, no one's able to fix it. But I don't know. They are hoping now that some other company will buy them, and they can just continue to make Van Moof bikes. Blah de blah de blah.
Yes.
Okay, so at this point, when I cross this big road, there will be a huge bridge going over the Amstel River. And after that, the boring part of this video is over. Unless you don't think this is boring. And by the way, don't forget to hit like down below and maybe leave a comment. If you hear this sentence of me, I'm asking you to leave a comment, and please, can you just, you know, just a few smileys already would make me happy.
Could be better. Could be worse.
Yeah, I'm mumbling in myself here in the video.
Yeah, my friend had an accident. That's why I'm bringing the bike from the volleyball hall to his house.
Yeah. Okay, so at...
That's what friends are for, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, I'm explaining indeed what's happening over there. And then now, last moment, I decided, you know what? Let me just do a voiceover. Let me just narrate.
Coming.
So, otherwise I wouldn't talk over there. Yes, I said something like a big bridge upcoming. Yeah, and it's a huge bridge. So now you see, I'm speeding up. The tricky thing is with two bikes that if there's like a little bump, my right hand will not be able to hold that bike. You know, I have to keep it fixed, eh? You understand? My wrists, the muscles in my fingers. If there's a little bump, then I'm fucked. But yeah, we'll see what happens. This is the Amstel River. Amsterdam thanks its name to this river. The Amstel River, they built a dam on top. They named it Amstel Dam, and later it changed to Amsterdam. So. Very good. And now we go down into the pipe area. Alrighty then. Here I'm doubting, shall I go to the left here or not? I decided not to. Because I thought, you know, it's nice maybe with the sunlight. But at this point I already felt my wrist and I thought like, you know what, I just want to be there ASAP. But I also thought, okay, this might be a tiny bit too boring. Huh? So after the next intersection, I'll decide to do a bit... Oh, no, right here. I decided to go to the left, right here. Yeah. I thought it was a bit further, yeah. A little bit dangerous, maybe, I don't know. For an inexperienced cyclist, let's say, because... Look at this, this is nice, these shots are nice. Okay, so now I'm gonna go to the right, and I'm like, oh no, they're breaking up the whole street. So I decided to go back a little bit.
Oh no.
Oh no.
They broke up the street over there, so let's go like this.
Mm-hmm. Ay, caramba.
Glad there's no car coming in the opposite direction right here. Cause
yeah, it's single way traffic in this little street, so I was lucky that there was no car. Yeah, a lot of bumps, as you can see. Small bumps, big bumps. But this is nice. Nice shots. Good lights.
Yeah, his bike sure makes a lot of sound.
Yeah. It really makes a lot of sound, like what the hell? And here we are at the Centuurbaan, the name of the street. Nice. Yeah. So yeah, the leaves are almost all gone, huh, from the trees. You see, some trees still have some leaves on them. Most are empty. You know, winter really, truly is coming, as they say in Game of Thrones. And maybe, yeah, let me know. Have you been in Amsterdam in this season? Yeah, like autumn / winter. I noticed there's a lot of less people coming to Amsterdam these months. So hotels are also cheaper, etc. Yeah, so that's the street they broke up, eh, on the right, what I was talking about earlier. And still just going over the Centuurbaan. In a moment you'll see me go past the Sarfati Park. Look at these trees. They're still standing. They're still standing. Yeah, yeah, yeah. They're still standing. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh yeah, there's a tricky part coming up. At the end of this park, so... Uno secondo, por favor. Yeah, it's just a bit sad that you don't see the second bike, you know? Like, the camera angle... I mean, the camera is already pretty wide, but... Maybe I should have put it more to the right. And now it's just really in the middle of my chest, the camera. But yeah, you don't see that I'm holding two bikes. I mean, come on, so much trouble. So if I ever do this a second time, you know, maybe for fun, maybe if you want me to do this a second time, I can just, you know, do this again with his bike, just for fun. He's not able to walk, oh, okay, he's not able to cycle for the upcoming months anyways. So if you want me to do that, then just leave a comment. Okay, look at this. Look at all these cars and look at how tight, with two bikes, eh? There we go. Especially this one here. I'm a magician. I mean, the steering wheel of his bike was really in my belly. And now I'm just going on purpose in front of that car, you know, so he's not able to go past me, eh? And I thought, you know what, I'm just gonna go to the left here. Why not? You know, it was still, you know, red, but he was going, this other truck, so yeah, let's just go and follow him. There we go. I think the name of this church is the Oranje Kerk, or the Orange Church. I see orange flags also. Oh, it's open. I've never been inside. Yeah, so this is the pipe area, P-I-J-P. You know, a very highly popular area. So if people can't find a house in the center, you know, the pipe is also, you know, let's say it's number two to live at. And in the olden times, it became popular because of the red light district. There was also like a red light district here. And now to this day, there's still a tiny little red light district left here in the pipe. You will not see that in this video, unfortunately, or maybe fortunately, I don't know. But yeah. So it was really, you know, a very popular area in the olden times with a lot of bars, rats running around, red light district. But now people really want to live here. And also, you know, tourists just go here to walk around and, you know, go to the market, etc. Here's the Ferdinand Bolstraat, Ferdinand Bol Street. Ferdinand Bol was a student of Rembrandt, painter. And we're going strong. And by the way, so this is filmed all in the morning. It actually looks like evening now. It looks like the sun is setting, but no. The sun is rising. I mean, it's like 11 a.m. I'm doubting shall go to the right here or not. And I decided not to, I don't know, too difficult or something, you know, for me, for my wrist. So here on the right you'll see a hotel, which is now still, it's full of Ukrainian refugees. At least last I heard. So this hotel right here, Savoy. And let's go to the right, right here. Hatsiki day. This is also one of the few, one of the areas I grew up in. So as a kid, I moved in Amsterdam 4 times. And was this the third house? Yeah, so I was born next to the Skinny Bridge in the center of Amsterdam. Then we moved to the Old South area. Then we moved here to the Rivierenbuurt. Or no, this is still the pipe actually. No, it's still the pipe, but the old, the south side. So the north side of the pipe is like the popular side. And anyways, then my sister was born and we moved again to Buitenveldert, which is the outside fields or something. If I translate it. Okay, so at this point there was a cyclist, he was not so in a rush. I will talk about it. And he's now gonna go past me. Uh-huh. So I'm not like the Van Moof driver who's was ringing his bell, you know? This guy was waiting.
You know, there's kind of this mutual understanding among the cyclists that if you see a cyclist with another bike in his second hand, I mean in his other hand, his second bike, then, you know, they won't be as aggressive. So, because everyone knows how hard it is.
Yeah, at this point...
I mean, I guess so.
At this point, I already regretted starting this sentence because I was so...
A little bit out of breath here. Good cardio over here.
Exhausted.
Not just cardio, also my finger muscles in the right hand. I feel them. Yeah. And my wrist.
Yeah, so we're almost there. We're now going into the Old South. And... going up a huge street, the Apollo Street. So here on the right it will be. And then I'm just gonna follow this road for a while. At King's Day, this is also a very popular place for people to sell their stuff at the flea market. So if you've been to Amsterdam on King's Day and you've not been here on King's Day, then this is maybe something to check out. And maybe in the daytime, so in the daytime, the flea market, say you go to the Vondelpark, and maybe afterwards you also walk around at the Apollo Laan. Yeah, but now you hear my buddy's bike. Man. Yeah, horrible. Imagine if he had a YouTube channel cycling around through Amsterdam, it would be just... everyone would be deaf. Yet also, it's also handy, because it really shows like, okay, this road needs to be renovated. Yeah. So for example, this road right here, what I'm riding on right now, the Apollo Laan, well, they can, I don't know, rework it or something. I guess it's all the roots of the trees, you know, they're growing, and slowly but surely the whole bicycle path is being broken up. Yeah, almost there.
Getting there.
Mm-hmm. Stretching my fingers over here. That's how it goes. And on top of actually this whole cardio exercise with cycling with two bikes, this morning I also went to the gym. So it was a pretty intense day, and the day just started. So I did some chest and shoulder and back exercise. Then I cycled all the way to the east of Amsterdam to get his bike, and now all the way from east home. So the day started from my home, the Staatslieden neighborhood, to Leidse Square, get my gym partner, going to the gym, next to the Heineken Experience, and then from the gym to that volleyball hall to get the bike, and now all the way to his home. And yeah, of course, later today I'll go home again. So, a pretty good day, yeah. I mean, cardio-wise, slash not just cardio. Okay, I'm gonna go through the red light here. Sorry guys, hate me, blame me, there was no one coming, I had two bikes. Okay, look at this flower stand, huh? Let's change the subject here. Nice flowers. On the right you'll see the Hilton Hotel. Hilton, and you know, they got so much money. And I'm wondering, why don't you just refurbish your hotel? I mean, put some paint on it or something. It looks, I mean, now in the sun it looks nice maybe, yeah? But all my life, I'm 36 years old right now, this hotel, it never changed. Like, change, I mean, yeah, new layer of paint, change the logo. It looks horrible. It looks the same as when John Lennon was there last time. No joke. And again, through the red light. Okay, sorry guys, hate me. But again, no one was coming and I have two bikes, so, you know, cut me some slack, that's a proverb, eh? Yeah, the kids are screaming, this is elementary school over here, on the right. These houses also. They're huge. Yeah, so, okay, this bicycle route is not the most exciting route. I guess actually almost no one will be listening to this anymore. Yeah, maybe you started a video, maybe you scroll through it. But I guess I should narrate some more. And then I'll also just cycle through the center, hit some tourists, get some action there, and then narrate it. I mean, if you guys are enjoying it, because if, again, just like with the history videos, if no one is enjoying it, then I won't narrate. It's a lot of energy and time. There's another high school here, the Amsterdam Lyceum. So today it's Tuesday, but all the kids are free. Like all those schools, I don't know why. Yeah, I mean, usually on Wednesday, I thought it was like the day that the kids were going home earlier, but today on the 28th of November, it's not a special day also. So yeah, this is a little bit emotional for me, what I'm cycling past now. My grandma used to live here. So all my childhood, I was here in this neighborhood, this church. This is the street where my grandmother was living, the Olympiaweg, the Olympia Road. And then, you know, we always walked to the cheese shop, the milk shop here on the right, at this corner, that black building, that was the milkman, Albert the milkman. And then we went there to buy our milk and cheese. Then we went to the butcher to buy, you know, meat, and to Ursula, the perfume store, which is here on the right. And yeah, she smoked, so yeah, to buy her cigarettes at Astrid, stuff like that. Olden times, yeah, the 90s. So yeah. And again, the last red light. I'm sorry. That's how we do it here in Amsterdam. You know, you grab your chances wherever you can. So yeah, I used to walk here with my grandmother. And actually, this is, we're already, there. My buddy, he's living here in the streets, and I'll stop the video right now, otherwise you know exactly where he lives, and no. That's not nice, you know. Privacy, huh? So thank you so much for watching, really, and listening. If you made it, you know, here in this video, and I really appreciate you. But most important, I want you to appreciate yourself as well. See you guys in the next video. Ciao.